All right, so I'm on. Right, I've been slowly working away on this. As you can see there, I've finished the whole back end. The beer garden is, as we in the UK call it, a beer garden. It doesn't actually mean there's a garden there. But let me take you around what I've done so far. I'm experimenting with pavement textures. I've just put a different one on each pavement because I want to see what it looks like in game. I've created a whole section that basically I've been using the prologue mission that Spring Hill created as a donor, and which is up there, and I've just been pulling bits out of it and rotating them and changing the way they look, etc., for your map. But basically, that's now there's a doorway to the basement. Ooh, I've just realised. Bit of monster clip probably doesn't want to do that. All right, where was I? I think I've showed you this already. Guards barracks. And then servant quarters, cook and the maid, I guess. I guess if that's going to become a new door, then we're going to have to open it up. Right, so let's back out into the alleyway. I mean, some of you will recognise this from, I can't remember the name of that mission. What was it? The last job? The first job? Something. Hang on. Where are we? New job. That was it. I've just basically been modifying the layout of things. You'll recognise that, obviously, from the right-hand side of the Canterbury Tavern. And I've obviously flipped it round. Moved stuff, created an alleyway. Yeah, I'm testing this texture out to see if this will work, but it can always be changed. That's just another piece of street that I've copied over that I'm going to be ripping down to put places, etc. I'm thinking, I don't know at this point, but you'll see why when we get around the corner, I've had a waterway over here, sort of Thief 2 style. I think you've seen this. This is the first city gate for the tavern. I've put a different texture down here, which I think it works quite well. I used it in the elixir. I've gone through and changed a bunch of the textures, added windows on here. And there's the entrance to the beer garden, the back of the tavern, whatever you're going to call, give this name a tavern. It's just a simple archway with some brushwork that I've added to mirror the stuff from the tavern, because obviously it's the property of the tavern. I've extended the fences manually, because you can see there it's just three little patches, and they're so close at grid 0.125 that unless the player, even if the player in game gets right up close, they're not going to see the gap in between them. And I've extended the bottom of the fence as well, rather than stretching it, because things just don't look right when they're stretched. Some things, this a gate being one of them. I've just extended the bottom of that and bound that to the gate, and I'll make that. In fact, I'll use the same trick I used in the elixir. Basically, put a no-draw solid brush around the gate, and then make that frobable, and make the gate not frobable, and then put a frob pier so the whole thing frobs, no matter which angle you're looking at it. And then we go into the beer garden. I'll do the big reveal in a minute. I don't want to give away what I've got lined up, but there's two beer tables at the moment. Built up that house there, built up that house there, and if you look through here, you can see that little alleyway. I might provide a way up here so the player can get up here through there. But the big reveal is I've created a little canal around the back, so the tavern could get I don't know, beer deliveries through here, I guess, because back in those days, a lot of stuff, it was quicker to get it shipped by canal than it was by horse and cart. These are normal stones that I've just resized. Use the old rotation tweak on them because I wanted them to be resized in on two axes only, not all three. And I spent most of the morning getting this bloody thing right. Oh, man, it was just annoying trying to fill up that corner there. That's a brush that I made for the elixir that mirrors or mimics the existing modules. And I've just copied that from elixir and pasted it there because it was just a weird size. Nothing was lining up properly, and I was having to try and put gaps in various places. That I created. Where is it? Ungroup that. That is a new underpiece for these that lines up perfectly with those bits of wood that stick out. Again, the seam is underneath, it's just above that frame, so the player isn't going to really see it unless they look really hard for it. As you can see there, look, there's a tiny bit there. There. But again, the player isn't going to see that. It'll be dark underneath there anyway. And this, what inspired me to create this little canal area was behind closed doors. You know, the little area that you could get to and from, and a little bit of the training mission. I still may steal bits and bobs from the training mission. Obviously, I've got to put some debris and whatnot at the bottom of the canal. That's the water. I haven't turned it into an entity yet. It's just oh, another top tip, and I've got a filter on. When you're creating water, always use no draw solid liquid on all the face. It's a bit like Vispals. The only one surface you want the whole brush to be no draw solid liquid. So basically, you create your brush and Bob's your uncle, and then you apply your water texture to the top surface, like so, and that's it. I have created extra textures for these modules, but it just doesn't look right. So there's always these tiny gaps. Keep filling in. Now hopefully that's not going to leave too much of a gap up here. No, because they're there. And then what I did is I stole the electricity tower from the prologue mission and repurposed it. Just cut off the bottom two floors. Rejigged the boiler on the outside. Did some pipe work and whatnot. One to the tab and one to the building over there. And the other thing you'll probably notice is I had to create patchwork to extend the canal from that tunnel. So I've got patchwork there and two tunnels. It's not perfect, as you can see the texture compression there. Again, this would be done better if it was done with models. And where that model meets that patch doesn't quite line up. But so what I've done is I've moved the patch, lined it up as much as I can, so at the bottom and at the top it lines up, but I can't get the corners to line up. So what I've done is I've moved the patch just above the model, so from this angle all the player sees a seamless tunnel almost. Yeah, I'll have to do a little bit of tweaking there, but again you might not even see it from over here. And the one thing I forgot to import was some fencing. So let me do that now. Because I imported some fencing that I made from one of the campaign missions. Where are we? Got to put that up there. Where the hell did I save these? Could have sworn it was in here. There's a nice little wooden pier, a wooden balcony. I'm gonna have to put a few of those. Let's find somewhere nice to put that. Up there, I reckon. That was gonna become a balcony, etc. I never got around to finishing it off. Lovely jubbly. A nice little balcony for someone. Oh, I could move it there. See what it looks like down there. Yeah, it looks pretty good actually. Let's hide that one. Always like to get stuff lined up if at all possible. And that's tall enough up there that the player can't get up there. Yeah. I'll leave the bottom one in as well, just to see what it looks like. I might even put some of them up here, I reckon. Rejigged. What else has changed? I've added two doors here, changed the texture on the bottom. Potentially, oh yeah. What's different about that? Oh, for some reason, does that, I'm going to have to put a, it's missing the decal texture. The model itself is missing the decal texture. As you can see, the one next to it has got it, but that one doesn't. So that's going to look a bit weird. So I'll have to manually put some decal patches in there. Change the texture of that flat up there so it doesn't mirror. Although this whole courtyard was taken directly from the prologue mission. Or from new job, and then I've obviously just rejigged it, created new under bits instead of the ones that were there, because make it look different. What else? It's a little alleyway here. This is going to probably be a, at the moment it's taken straight from new job, but it's just to provide a fake alley or the illusion of the city expanding beyond where you are. And I've done the same thing here, again taken from new job. Right, that's it really. I don't think I've done anything internal that you haven't seen already. We still have to find what the hell is that floating spoon. There we go. One of these windows needs to be open, so I guess we could make one of those openable, or the toilet, which was originally openable. Oh, that's interesting. I've got the wrong module on the outside, on the inside. Okay, I'll have to flip that round, because I think you can make. There's one where there's a hole where there's openers for that type of window. It's either that window or that window, one or the other. And what are we up to? 15. I think I'll do for a status update, but let me know what you think. I mean, if this canal thing is completely wrong and you wanted a garden in there, I can just cut all of that canal and those two tunnels out and then extend the garden out and make it a green garden and then put a big tree in the back there. And it's not the end of the world if we have to do that. But I've seen beer gardens like this in real life. I never did import that flipping framework that we went looking for. I got distracted. No, that's not it. No. I know I bloody saved it from one of the missions. I went into it to copy it out. Where is it? this is annoying. I know, bloody say it. I went specifically went in to save these things out because I thought, oh yeah, it needs a fence along the canal. And now can't bloody find it. It's because I need some food and I'm tired. Fairly sure I put it under architecture. Oh yeah, there's another way around this. With Astro Grep, I can do a keyword search. Alright, well, that's doing its bloody search. I'm going to search for it manually again. Maybe I didn't save it in there then. Oh, there it is. Yeah, I made these a very long time ago. Okay, why didn't the rest of the... Oh, because I didn't select it. Tall as that. Let's get rid of. Where are we? I like to make things 6 things high at grid 4 or grid 8 even. Yeah, that's about right. You can just patches that are over the top of a brush, you can just do when they're in the same plane, you can just do a direct paste like that, and then they seamlessly blend in. But you get the little bumps there like that, which look cool. Now, where's the rest of that fence work? Yeah, I must do one beneath the. Where the hell is it? Oh, there we go. I think these ropes are a bit too big, but we'll see what it looks like. Oops, drew a brush instead of a selection. Let's take it all the way up to the edge of the stairs, the steps. Always get the ropes to look like they're naturally. Nice group there. I guess I'll have to have a look at it in game, see what it looks like. Yeah, that looked like the spacing's a bit off. Yeah, what would you reckon? Too tall, maybe? Every time you move a patch, the texture doesn't move with it, so you just have to do a copy and paste. Right. don't know, the fencing just not screaming docks to me. Let's look at a picture of a wooden dock. Well, I was mostly there. That's what I was aiming for. See if there's some real pictures. Come on, there's gonna be some oldie shots around here somewhere. Basically that, but with those kind of posts in between. I think I've sort of done that. Maybe the spacing's too close together. Maybe that's what the problem is. Just the vibe is. And that maybe get rid of those bottom posts as well. So get rid of those. Get rid of one of the poles. We got here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 5, 3, 4, 5. Nope. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. Maybe have less of these rope bits, or make them more rope. Yeah, let's make them more rope. As in that pole there, I think that'll add, rather than these grey ones in between. Oops, didn't mean to do that. I meant to ungroup them. Stabling. That's better. Steal some tankards and whatnot. Nice. Basically, the way the player, players, sorry, and the player, the AI or members of the guests, I should say, there's the toilets, there's the gambling room, so they can either walk through the gambling room or they can walk through the main foyer from there. I did consider putting one there as well, but then that takes us to outside the, into this courtyard. Anyway, what are we up to? Alright, half an hour. Did I find... No, it didn't. Let me know what you think, and let me know what changes you want me to make, etc. from here. I think this little canal beer garden looks kind of cool.